Children, welcome to another EVS 1 class today. Let's start our today's period with lesson number 9. It is just the revision which we had in our last Zoom session, lesson number 9, Maps are Companions. Okay, so let's begin our today's period with a wonderful thought. Worrying does not take away tomorrow's troubles, it takes away today's peace. Okay, so if you worry about something, it will only take today's peace. It will not change your problem, it will not solve your problem. So our lesson begins with landforms. Remember, I told you in the last Zoom session. So what are children landforms? These are the different types of lands you see, different shapes of the land you see around yourself because of the difference in heights and slopes. These are called landforms. So again, I repeat this, the different shapes of the land form due to differences in heights and slopes are called landforms. For example, mountains, valleys, plateaus means plain land, isn't it? Plains. Islands, these are some of the examples of landforms. These are the different shapes, you know, mountains, valleys. So these are formed because of the height or slope of the land. Now maps, why we need maps? Maps are used since ancient times, isn't it? So considering the difference in heights, slopes, shapes, different landforms can be shown on a map. You can show any kind of landform, any type of land on the map. Okay, so these are used since ancient times. Junya divsanpasun use hota hai maps. So the length and width of the landform can easily be shown on a map, but the height and depth cannot be shown easily. So different methods are used to show various landforms. Okay, length and width is easily, it could be easily shown. But what are the methods which are used to show various landforms? Okay, specifically here we are talking about the height, children. So different methods of showing landforms. First method is said to be the contour line method. Now what is this method? It is used to show unevenness of the landforms. Unevenness when the land is not same. It's not even, it's not same. The method, in this method what happens? The height of the land is measured from sea level. And in this method, points of the same height are identified and these points are joined with a line. So lines joining the locations of the same height are called contour lines. So what we do? We identify the same points. And then a line is drawn between those same points. Okay, and that line to measure the height is called the contour line. I think the diagram will make you the things more clear. Contour lines. See how lines are drawn on the same height, on the same point, isn't it? It is basically used to measure, isn't it? So such lines are drawn, children, on the same points. See, here on the same point, the lines are drawn. These are known as the contour lines. Okay, like here. Now to show the gentle slope. See how is the shape, and to show the steep slope you can see here. This is a gentle slope, tivra utar, it is steep slope, and here madhyam utar, isn't it? That is a gentle slope. So this is how contour line is shown here. So these are basically what, children? These are the lines which are drawn on the same point of the same height. See, the points are same. This line is drawn on the same point, this line is drawn on the same point. So basically these are the lines joining the same points. These are said to be the contour lines. Okay. The second method is what, children? Layer tinting method. Okay. So layer tinting method is what? Here see, different colors are shown. Basically what? Different colors are shown to show the height on the map. See, for every height color is different, isn't it? See, for all these different measurements, or for all these different heights, different colors are there. Somewhere you see dark blue, green, dark brown, isn't it? So this is called what, children? Layer tinting method. And then this is what? Digital elevation model. Okay, this is the third method, digital elevation model. Now this is more clear, this is the more advanced technology nowadays, modern technique which we use to show the map. With the help of this map, with the help of this technology, now you can locate any place on the earth, you can measure the height. So here you can see the elevation height more clearly. So this is the modern method, digital elevation model. But how we make maps with this method, children? With the help of artificial satellites. Artificial satellites which move around the earth, no, they take the pictures, they take the images. And then we can easily identify the map, or we can easily find out the location. This is the way to make the map, by digital elevation model, modern technique. But how these maps are made? With the help of artificial satellites which move around the earth's surface. So we'll read out what is about first, second method, layer tinting method, colors. So this method is based on what, children? Contour line only. But the spaces between the contour lines are filled with what, children? Colors. So here colors are shown. So each color indicates a specific height. We just saw one picture, no? So for example, water bodies are always colored with blue, whereas adjoining land is always colored dark green. You will see on any map now, water bodies are always shown with blue color, okay? And the land higher than that is light green. And in this method, index is always given in the map, children. Wherever you will find the map now, in every map, index is always given, okay? So, the yes, the differences in the colors between the contour lines showing differences in the physical setup of the land can be identified. Yes, so basically what this is, the colored method to show the height. Digital elevation model, so this is the most modern method where the artificial satellites, man-made satellites are used to draw the maps, and the difference in the height, everything you can show with the help of digital elevation model, children. Now what are signs and symbols? So many components are shown on a map. We show so many things on the map, but to avoid confusion, standard signs and symbols are used in the map. And key is what, children? Index. Index is always given in the map. So these are the signs and symbols. Like for fort, symbol is specific. For mountain, symbol is specific. Isn't it? For sea, symbol is specific. For river, symbol is specific, standard. Just to avoid the confusion. So let's go into the more detail of signs and symbols. Now what is the difference between signs and symbols? See, this is the sign, this is the symbol, but this is the sign. Okay, whenever letters are written, it is a sign. And whenever such pictures are there, it is the symbol. This first symbol is for the right to education, children. Okay, this first symbol is right to education. See, boy and girl sitting on the pencil, this is the symbol for right to education. It is every child's right to have the primary education. Second symbol is for Doordarshan. It is the old mode of, means of communication. No? Doordarshan is old channel, said to be the old channel. When I was in my childhood days, I used to watch this channel only, Doordarshan. Nowadays, you have so many other channels, so many. But in my childhood days, this was the only channel which I used to watch. Third is, this is the ladies and gents toilet. This plus sign is for it is a symbol for hospital. This is for school ahead. See, child is running, triangle, that means the school is ahead. It makes vehicles aware, it makes people aware that the school is just nearby, so you should always slow down the vehicles. So this is the symbol for school ahead. This one is very peculiar to you. This symbol you know very well, Balbharti. Balbharti books which you have for English and Marathi, this is a symbol for Balbharti education, isn't it? Now this is the sign, children. See, letters are written, so this is the sign. This is the sign for PO, that is post office, okay? Then this is the symbol for harbor, anchor sign, symbol for harbor. Port where ships wait, this is the symbol for harbor. Then lighthouse, fort, I told you for fort symbol is different. Burial ground, just to bury the dead bodies, this is the burial ground. Then international boundary line, many countries are connected, they have their boundaries, so this is the international boundary line. See how it is, okay? These are again some of the symbols. This is the symbol which is used for battlefield, railway track, symbol, well, vihir, spring, to show the small lake, spring, it is the symbol which is used, triangulation mark, then settlement, then grass, contour line, symbol for contour line, see how it is, for lake, this is the symbol, and then for road, this is the symbol, okay, mine, black color symbol is there, RF, reserve forest, RF, now this is the sign, RF, reserve forest, this is a sign which is used for reserve forest. So these are some of the signs and symbols. I gave you the answers here, children, which we saw just here. These are the answers, okay? Here, the boxes, empty boxes are there. All these answers I have given here. So, first symbol, right to education, Doordarshan, ladies and gents toilet, hospital, school ahead, Balbharti. Now what is the Survey of India? See, this is a symbol which is used for Survey of India, Bharatiya Sarvekshan Vibhag. Now what is the specialty of this department, children? Survey of India. This particular Institute of India, it makes map for it, specially only for India. Okay, so they have their own satellite system which makes map only for India. This department, this office, in other words, we can say the name of that office is the Survey of India. Okay. Now what is your today's homework, children? You have to write down about the meanings of landforms, that is contour line method, layer tinting method, digital elevation model, and write down all signs and symbols and also draw them. Okay, so you have to draw from the textbook all these signs and symbols which we saw just now, along with their names in your notebook without fail. I will again show you which things you have to write down in your notebook. Okay, so this one, different methods. You will start writing from here, different methods of showing landforms. So contour line method, then yes, even you can draw this diagram also after contour line method. Layer tinting method also you can draw. You don't have to draw this one. No need to draw this one. But you will start your homework writing with this one, this slide, contour line. Okay, so you will start your work with this, then this diagram. Of course, the layer tinting method, this diagram, this you don't have to draw. Then you will again write down this one, layer tinting method, digital elevation model, this also you will write down in your notebook information. These signs and symbols you will draw without fail in your notebook, and in front of every sign and symbol you will write down these names. Okay, see, you will draw everything and you will write down the name also. So answers are given here for this particular. So these are the answers. Okay, these empty boxes, the answer is this. Okay, so I want all these things in your notebook, completed work till this in your notebook before you give your copy for submission, before you will give your copies to me for correction. Okay, so I want all exercise question answers to be completed till lesson number 9, along with all these signs, symbols, diagrams, everything in your notebook, children. Okay, if you give me incomplete notebooks, I am going to call the parents and write down your proper name, class, section, subject, everything. Submit your copies properly. Okay, I want to have your copies properly to be given to me. Okay. Okay, so bye to all of you, and without fail complete your notebooks. Only lesson till only 9 lessons you have to complete, so you can do it. Without fail, I want this complete work in your notebook. Okay, children, bye then, and we will again meet in the next period.